Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, on this day where we remember your resurrection, help us to feel your presence. Help us to feel and know that you are always with us. We give you thanks for your Son who died and rose again for us. Even in these stormy times, we know you are with us because the women and the disciples witnessed your presence. Help us to witness your presence in this service. Help us always to hear your voice, and help us always to answer your call. Give us the strength and courage to do your work in the world so that others might see the resurrected Christ in us. And we ask and pray all this in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our opening hymn is 179.
Thank you. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Jeremiah. At that time, says the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. But Israel sought for rest. The Lord appeared to him from far away. I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, I have continued my faithfulness to you. Again, I will build you, and you shall be built, O virgin Israel. Again, you shall take your tambourines and go forth in the dance of the merrymakers. Again, you shall plant vineyards on the mountains of Samaria. The planters shall plant and shall enjoy the fruit. For there shall be a day when sentinels will call in the hill country of Ephraim, come, let us go up to Zion, to the Lord our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray together from Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now proclaim,
his mercy endures forever.
The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. There is a sound of exultation and victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them.
I will offer thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. He who is righteous may enter. I will give thanks to you for your ministry and have become my salvation. The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and he is marvelous in our eyes. On this day that the Lord has acted, we will rejoice and be glad in it.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hymn number 210, verses 1 and 2. Fear of him, the guards shook
and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are here looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised. As he said, come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb and quickly, with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I want you to think about what that must have felt like to them, to think something has happened, something we can't explain, something that we are afraid of, something that terrorizes us. And then I want you to think about something that has happened to you that was the most glorious thing you could ever imagine. Whether it be the birth of a child, a nephew, a cousin, Maybe it was someone that came into your life that made you feel so good, better than you had ever felt before. That must have been the joy that the women felt when Jesus stood before them. This is a day where that, I hope and I pray, happens for each of us. That we feel this joy that Jesus has risen. Jesus went through all of this just for us. Just for each one of us. Yes, Jesus died and rose again for the world. But Jesus knew us each by name. When he hung on that cross, and when he rose, I can just imagine him running through the list of all the names that would ever be. Seeing our faces, being glad that this day happened for just us. It's an amazing thought. It's an amazing time to think that even in this time where we are sequestered, we are doing the stay-at-home quarantine, however you're doing that, though I know most of us are getting out some. But just thinking of even in this time, Jesus walks with us. We meet him face to face every day. What I really hope is that you meet Jesus face to face in the faces of everyone you see. You see, this story that we're told about this resurrection doesn't mean anything if we don't see Jesus in each other. This story of the resurrection only means something because he came to dwell in us. He came for each one of us. He came to raise us from this death of sin, this death that will happen in this mortal life, so that we too will be raised from the dead. How glorious will it be on that day when we see Jesus face to face, when we see him actually bodily standing in front of us and understand how the two Marys, and even after a while, the disciples get to see Jesus face to face. You know, I don't know how many of you that excites as much as it does me. It brings tears to my eyes to imagine that day. This is a day that is supposed to be the most celebrated day in the Christian year. And yet, somehow, some way, Jesus has allowed this day to happen. Not 20 years ago when none of this technology really existed. And certainly not the way it is now. A day when I couldn't have been a televangelist just by turning on a phone. But today, Jesus allowed this to happen in a time where even though we are connected in this building, in this place, we are connected. We can connect through social media. We can connect in ways that we could never have imagined. I hope and I pray this Sunday, this Easter Sunday, though storms may be outside, though we may be sequestered in our homes, though we may be fighting something we do not understand and can't understand, that the one thing we understand is that Jesus rose victorious over all of these things. And I don't want you to hear me wrong. That does not mean that Jesus rose and cured everything in such a way that we cannot use the intelligence God gave us. God gave us intelligence to understand that if you are gathered in huge crowds in churches today, you are not doing that because God has called you to do that. Because God did not call us to come into these buildings and risk our lives. God called us to be the church of the world. Jesus didn't stay in the tomb when he rose. He didn't stay in one place when he rose. No, he went out into the world to make sure that the world knew the church was among them. Yes, one day this will pass, and we will be able to gather again in these buildings. And I hope and I pray that just as this Easter service normally is overfilled with people in the building, we will see that again, because people will know from those of us who still find a way to connect, even through the media, that we are excited about the risen Christ and what the risen Christ means to us and in us. So, as we leave this day, as we begin the weeks after Easter, don't let that excitement go away, because Jesus should be exciting every day. Jesus should excite us because Jesus died just for me and just for you, and rose for the same reasons. And then, as Jesus dwells in us, let us go out and be the church to all those who may know Jesus personally and those who have no clue, those who may have believed and lost their faith, and those who are still walking in faith. Let us be that light that shines. Let our radiance show, because Christ flows out from us. Let us be that gift that Jesus gave us on this Resurrection Sunday, this Sunday we call Easter. And let us be the gift that everyone sees, because Christ lives in us. Christ is resurrected in us, and it is up to us to live out that resurrection in our lives so others might see him through us. Enjoy the rest of this Easter tide. Enjoy it in a way that reflects our faith. And let the world know that Christ is risen, has risen today just as Christ rises every day. Please join with me in the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please join me in the prayers of the people. Christ has burst through the tomb of death, victorious over its power, revealing the triumph of light over every darkness. In thanksgiving, we offer our prayers, responding, "Hear us, O risen Christ." In thanksgiving for the resurrection of Jesus, who empties our spiritual tombs and reveals the way to abundant life, let us pray,
"Hear us, O risen Christ."
For the leaders of the nation, especially Donald, our president, that they may guide the world to a greater fulfillment of its quest for freedom, justice, and peace. Let us pray,
Hear us, O risen Christ.
For the innocent in troubled places, and wherever strife stifles harmony, that the actions of the global community may free all who are suffering or imprisoned unjustly. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
For the church, for the bishops throughout our Anglican communion, and especially Michael, our presiding bishop, and Larry, bishop of our diocese, and for each of us, that we may embrace the mystery of the Pascha and give witness to the living Christ in our midst. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
Christ, the wounded healer, has overcome all that can threaten us. Let his resurrection power bring healing and hope to those for whom we pray, especially for those infected with the COVID-19, healthcare workers, retail workers, first responders, all those who risk themselves to ensure we can get what we need. Mary, Elizabeth, Hallis, Jim, Monty, Jane Ann, John, Martha, Joel, Jesse, Sandy, Peter, Chris, David, Kirk, Bill and the Edwards family, and the Wendy family. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
In thanksgiving for the faithful departed, especially Barbara, Gail, and those who have left us an inheritance of God's blessings, and who now join in the chorus of angels and the saints in paradise. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
In thanksgiving for all who have gathered here today to share in this Holy Eucharist, that we may each be changed by the message of new life and the food of eternal hope, growing richly and fully into the forgiving compassion of Jesus. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
For those who do not yet believe and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O Lord. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
O God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation, and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel, especially Mark. Surround them with your loving care, protect them from every danger, and bring them in safety to their journey's end, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us pray.
Hear us, O risen Christ.
Christ, morning star, shine in us and through us as we continue our prayer together. Lord, you have called us to serve you. Grant that we may walk in your presence, your love in our hearts, your truth in our minds, your strength in our wills, until at the end of our journey, we know the joy of our homecoming and the welcome of your embrace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Those things, good Lord, that your servants have prayed for, give us grace to work for, and in the purpose of your love, answer our prayers and fulfill our hopes for Jesus' sake. Amen. And if you would, we're going to go ahead, even though we are meeting virtually, and pray for our folks that have birthdays and anniversaries. So if you would pray with me together for Shani and Susan. Oh God, our times
are in your hands.
Look with favor, we pray, upon your servants, Shani and Susan,
that they begin under you.
Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And then we'll do the anniversary pair. We have half of the anniversary couple. Let us pray for Scott and Rhonda. Oh God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessings upon these your servants, Scott and Rhonda, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
How many years?
26. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So, I am so pleased that we have wonderful singers from St. John's to help lift us up in music. I want to thank Marissa for playing the harp so beautifully for us. We wanted to make this at least as special as we could for an Easter service where most of you are watching me. And like I said, I've become a televangelist just by opening up a phone, which is amazing to me. I also want to give you a little different instructions. We will have the lunches to go, but I'm going to ask you if you can imagine the church. There is a handicap ramp on the side of the narthex, which is at the back of the nave, which is the church we worship in. And if you will pull around to that side, there is a place where I can get you that, where I won't get soaking wet bringing you the to-go lunches. If you haven't ordered to-go lunches, we have plenty, so please join us in this feast together. If you have a special request, then you'll probably not get that special request. You're going to get ham and lamb and the works. So please know that that is going to be available between noon and 1 to pick up here at the handicap ramp. I will be there, so if you don't see me, just keep coming around the building. You'll eventually see me. So that's what I'll tell you about that. I will. Becky and I both are going to be off tomorrow. If you need me, as usual, you have my cell phone number. You are welcome to use that, and I would ask you if you need me to please use it. That's what I have it for. That's what I'm here for. I can't read your minds or know what you need if you don't let me know. So please let me know when you need something. We will continue our weekly schedule, not this coming week, but the following week. We will again begin at 9 a.m. every morning, Monday through Thursday, with the Lord's Prayer together and some other prayers. I'm going to take actually Monday and Tuesday off, so I won't even be around the office. If you would like to join the vestry meeting, hoping that Zoom is working, we will have our vestry meeting by Zoom on Wednesday at 6:30. So you're welcome to join us by Zoom on that if you would like to. Everything else should be in your bulletin. It comes in your constant contact. We'll continue to do video messages through this time where we are practicing distancing. We may even do a stay-at-home order before it's over, but we haven't gotten there yet. I hope that all of you are enjoying this Easter, even though it's raining. If for some reason something comes up, please give me a call. Let me know. I want to be there for you as best I can. We have people who are ill and they need your prayers. If I have not contacted you, I'm continuing to work through the directory. But please remember that we are one big family. And so people expect me to call. I expect you to call each other. Pull out your directories. Call each other. It's a way of staying in touch. It's a way of passing the peace when we can't touch each other. So please remember to call each other. Share your love with each other by calling or texting or however you decide to communicate. But communicate with each other so that when we come back together again, we won't sort of be strangers. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God. Against you, and we betrayed your trust. and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. But in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood he reconciled us. By his wounds we are healed.
And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope and proclaimed with them the glory of your unending hymn. And offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving.
We celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming.
Lord God of our fathers and mothers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of Deborah, Rachel, and Leah, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Praise the Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Take care.
Let us pray together our post-communion prayer found in your bulletin. Father of all,
we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you passed in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and overcame the glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We who in the Spirit lights give life to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Amen.
And may the Spirit pour its life and blessing upon us. May we remember that Christ is risen. And because Christ is risen, we too will rise again. And that the light of Christ would shine through us to all the world. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and evermore. Amen. Our closing hymn is hymn number 207.
Jesus Christ is risen today. Oh, hallelujah.
invite you to stay tuned for the postlude that Marissa will do on the harp. So please stay tuned with us for that. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.